afternoon and in the evenings, as we've been seeing. We've had this is June gloom in full force. June gloom will continue throughout this week. You can see it's going to be very mild. We're going to be actually below average. June gloom is normal, but we're usually up about the upper 70s, 77, 78. And it looked like as we got to next weekend, we were going to see that. But it seems like this is going to be kind of the pattern, at least for the next 5 to 7 days. So not much change. Looking around Orange County and the area today, it's funny. I looked last week, as I update the Monday one every once a week, right? So last week, all these temperatures were up by 20 degrees. We were in the 90s, if you recall. So in a way, this is kind of nice. Palm Spring is still going to be nice out there, warm at 103. But everywhere else, below normal. Beaches are only going to see maybe 65 degrees. So, a little bit cool out there. We were at the beach yesterday down in Laguna. And yes, the June gloom was there, and it was a little cool. But it was kind of nice to get down there before all the art shows begin. Those are fun to go to, but it gets really crowded down there. So if you got a chance to get down to those areas over the next couple of weeks before all the art shows start, I really encourage it, because it's kind of nice. It's easy parking and get around easy. So, good time of the year to go, despite the June gloom. All right, we'll be back in just a moment.
When you travel with AAA, you get more than a vacation. You get exclusive AAA member benefits, special offers on unforgettable experiences, and the travel planning knowledge of your own AAA travel agent. When you travel with AAA, you get the vacation of your dreams. To save on a pleasant holidays vacation, visit your local AAA travel agent today.
Saddleback Medical Center, we are a MAGNIC designated facility, which means that we're in the top 8% of hospitals across the nation that are recognized for high quality patient outcomes and nursing excellence. And what that means is that we have nurses that are highly engaged and enthusiastic about their workplace, that we have lower vacancy rates, lower turnover, and high nursing satisfaction scores.
We all know there's no place like home. You want to stay in your own home, but day-to-day tasks are getting more difficult to manage. ActiCare is the solution. We are the trusted care partner in your community with 5-star reviews. You've taken care of others all your life. Now is the time to let us help you. In-home care is a safe and effective way to help you remain living independently in the comfort of your own home.
ActiCare, responsive in-home care. Your first day is free.
The Red Sox are one out away. And the Dodgers are down to their final strike. Here comes a 1-2 pitch. Red Sox win the World Series! And the best team in baseball wins it all.
At family-owned Capistrano Toyota, I've been teaching my staff for years that we always say yes to our customers.
Can you help me get financed?
Yes, we can help.
Will you walk my dog?
Yes.
Will you change our baby's diapers?
Yes, of course.
But they may be taking this yes thing a little bit too far. Come and see for yourself that at Capistrano Toyota, we always say yes to our customers.
Well, with you right now is Richard Palmer. He is the president of the Tea Party Sentinels here in Laguna Woods. And next week, next Monday, they'll be having their regular meeting. And I'd like to welcome you. Good to see you, sir.
Thank you, Ken.
And this meeting coming up is a little bit different, right?
Right. I'm really excited about this. This is the first time we have a bunch of college students talking about their experiences. Mm-hmm. I know there's been a lot of roll-to-roll going on all over the country, but now I want to bring it to a head. And it all started with one guy from a small town in Kentucky.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Hayden William.
Mm-hmm.
He was at Berkeley. He was a senior at Berkeley. And one day they were out, he was promoting the conservative ideas, and some hoodlum from outside the campus came over and started harassing him. And I saw this on television. Mm-hmm. Somebody had the sense to televise the whole thing. And they hassled him and they wrestled a while, and all of a sudden this guy just hauled off and smacked him right in the face.
Wow.
I couldn't believe it. And so the next thing I found out is that he's on the Hannity show, and then he was at one of President Trump's rallies.
Wow.
And I just couldn't believe that he made such a grand statement.
Right, right.
But, you know, he took that punch for all of us.
Yeah.
So
he's the one that's going to be there, or a few other
students?
He's
not. No, I asked him if he could, but he's up north.
Okay, all right.
So I have to call him and find out when he's available, but we are going to have him.
Okay.
And this is.
But you have a few other college students, am I right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's what I thought. All right.
Oh, yeah. From private and mm-hmm. public colleges. So we want to get the whole perspective. And as a matter of fact, there is a difference between the public and private colleges. But they both have some form of harassment, but mm-hmm. it's not as prevalent on in private colleges.
Right, I would think that, yeah.
Yeah. So I thought it was a great opportunity to bring this whole thing forward.
Yeah.
And but there's so much going on right now. I look back in my college days, and you know, we never talked politics. Everything was to get a profession,
right? You know, right.
Training, but today, that's the public political situation is primary on campuses, mm-hmm. and I don't know how to reverse that because so many. I think 90% of the professors are left or. Sort of leftish.
Right, right. And probably in the public colleges. Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
But even in the private colleges, you have some. Mm-hmm. That's why I wanted to have both students there to explain the differences. But there is a significant thing. The thing that I get is really disturbing is how all these 22 some people running against Trump in 2020.
Right.
And they are so far left, and in order to gain traction against the other guys, they're going even further
right,
left.
Right, right.
I figure, what the heck is going on? I mean,
yeah.
But they wanted free colleges, free medical, everything free,
mm-hmm.
and that's not even possible. I look at what happened in Venezuela.
Right,
and
right.
That's a prime example, a very recent. Well, mm-hmm. it's sort of recent experience, and over the years, in the last century, I think 60 million people were killed by these governments that were controlled by the far left.
Mm-hmm.
China, Russia, Cuba. I mean, but they don't recognize that.
Right.
And
how many college students are you expecting for this?
I have no idea.
Okay.
I made some phone calls, and we have Brooke Paz. She was already a speaker 2 months ago, and she's going to come, and I asked her to bring some students.
Okay.
And I talked to a couple other students. So I know we have at least three or four.
Okay.
But I don't, you know, you can have a stage full, but they're just repeating themselves.
Right, right.
But I'm really looking forward to this because I think people have to realize the impact that the colleges are having
right,
on kids.
Right.
And it's all based on, they're not learning about our Constitution. They're not learning about any real history. It's all slanted.
Mm-hmm.
And somehow this got to be straightened out. I mean, it's just amazing all the nonsense that's going on. So again,
next Monday.
Yep.
Not today. I want to make sure people know that. The 24th at right. Clubhouse 7 at 7 o'clock. Doors open at 6:30.
That's right.
So, all right.
Anyway, we're really excited about this. I don't know what's going to happen. It's up to the students to come up with our ideas.
And something stuff. A little bit different.
Yeah, but I told them, we're not looking to give a speech.
Right.
We just want you to explain the circumstances mm-hmm. you ran into and what you did, if you could do anything, to try and stop
it. Yeah. All right. Very good. Everyone's invited.
Everybody's invited.
Yeah, no matter what your views are, it might be a good idea if your view is different to come and hear what college students have to say.
Yeah, well, you know, when Bill Sinclair was last month when he was at our meeting, we had a great audience, and of course he's a great speaker.
Right, right.
And he just touched on the subject, but because he's trying to cover the whole broad spectrum. And it's just amazing. But I'm really concerned about what these young, I mean, all, you know, they want free stuff. Well, how far can you go?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, somebody pays for it, no matter what.
Yeah.
All right.
When they run out of other people's money.
Yeah, then what? All right, Richard, thank you so much for coming in.
Oh, you're
I appreciate
quite welcome.
It. And again, this is next Monday, the 24th. Tea Party Sentinels, you can find them online. Just go ahead and do what I do. Just Google Tea Party Sentinels, Laguna Woods, and you'll get right to the site with all the information.
Thank you very
much.
Good
to see you.
Yeah, thank you.
Take care. We'll be right back.
Yeah, it's a...
Did you know that we are living longer, healthier lives than ever before? And did you know that social interaction, brain stimulation, and exercise improve your quality of life? Did you know the Saddleback College Emeritus Institute offers 200 tuition-free classes to older adults in South Orange County? With over 30-plus locations between Lake Forest and San Clemente, it has never been easier to take advantage of your third act of life. Sign up today.
Thank you for joining us. Today I have Dr. Judy Rose, who is the National Director of PET CT for RadNet. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for interviewing me.
So tell me exactly what a PET CT scan is.
Well, PET CT scan is a specific piece of equipment that's a marriage between a CT scan, which is an anatomic picture of a patient, and a metabolic picture, which is the PET portion. Those two are two different modalities that are put together in one scanner and show us both anatomy and function or physiology of the patient. And that means for a patient who we're looking for cancer, which is the major reason for doing a PET CT, we can see metabolism of the cancer. We can see how it's functioning, not just a change in size, but is it actually an active cancer or a non-active cancer?
Okay. And then what can a patient expect when they're having a PET CT exam?
Well, the patient will arrive at the center with a certain set of instructions. Because we're going to be injecting something that's a radioactive substance, but it's actually sugar. So we have to have you be without any food or water for at least 6 to 8 hours, mm-hmm. because if you eat a candy bar, that sugar will interfere with the sugar that we give you and our ability to see the cancer. So when you come in, you'll have a PET CT technologist who is a specialist in performing this exam, and they will give you an intravenous injection of radioactive sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Now it takes about 45 minutes for that tracer to localize in the cancer and in some normal structures. So we do see your brain because you need sugar to think and talk. And we do see your heart because it's very active in the muscle for pumping blood. Mm-hmm. So we see other organs. But to actually get to the cancers, it takes about 45 minutes of uptake time. Oh. During that time, you will be in a room with a magazine and a television, and you'll be able to just rest while we wait for the uptake time.
Okay.
Then you'll be brought in where the equipment is. It is actually similar to a CT scanner in that it has a donut, it has a hole, and you have to go through it. Mm-hmm. And the length of time it takes depends how tall you are. So if you're very tall, it's going to take a little bit longer because we have to go all the way from your eyes all the way down to about your knees. Mm-hmm. And if you're short like I am, it's going to not take as long.
Oh, I guess the short ones have the advantage.
Yes. So in general, most scanners 20 to 25 minutes. You'll be, but your head won't be in it, but very, very short period of time. Okay. The rest of it will be down from your eyes down.
All right.
And then you'll be free to leave, and there'll be no side effects afterwards. You won't feel funny. You can go out for lunch, and you can enjoy the rest of your day.
Now, you said they had to be free of food and water for 6 to 8 hours. Is that just a fasting the night before?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. All right, perfect. And then what advantage is there to undergoing a PET CT scan other than what you've already mentioned?
Well, traditionally and still, many oncology patients are studied with traditional CT scans, mostly of the neck, chest, abdomen, and pelvis. When you look at a CT scan, you're looking at only size and sometimes changes in the shape of a tumor, but that could be, once that tumor is treated, it may still be growing as it necroses, but it doesn't mean it's an active tumor. Mm. Or it could be a very small mass. CT interpretations are done by size, so you could have a very small lymph node or a place that the tumor can spread to that's below 5 or 8 millimeters, and it would be considered normal on a CT scan. But once you add in the radioactive sugar, we don't have that problem because we can see that the sugar is metabolizing in the site of the tumor. Mm-hmm. You can only do that if you have the test done as one entity. So it's much better for the doctors, because the referring doctors, because we can monitor your treatment. So if you have a PET CT study done at the time of diagnosis and you undergo treatment, whether that be surgery, radiation, or chemotherapy, we can tell if you're responding to the chemo, or if you're or whether the tumor was completely resected at the time of surgery. Because if there's metabolism or sugar left, there's still tumor that needs to be treated, or you may not be responding to the type of chemo that you're currently administered.
Okay. And then in which clinical situation would a PET CT scan be administered?
In almost all cancers, it is now approved and used for initial staging. That means at the time you present, to be sure. So if you come in and we see something on your chest x-ray or CT that has a mass, we don't know if it's just confined to the chest. Mm. So we will, about 40% of the time, we will upstage the patient. So they come in and they think it's local disease, but it is not local disease, mm-hmm. which completely changes management. We then, the second indication is once you've had either surgery or you're on therapy, to monitor the response to the treatment. Mm-hmm. And so we do it in follow-up to determine whether we see any more cancer, or if the patient is or is not responding to treatment, so it needs to be changed.
Okay. And then we talked about radiologists in another interview that we had. What kind of radiologist would be specific to this type of exam?
Well, it's a very difficult exam to interpret, and it should be done by what we call an oncology radiologist or an oncologic radiologist. That is someone who is training in both the anatomic imaging, which is CT, but also in the metabolic or physiologic part, which is PET. So it should be a radiologist who can interpret both of those exams, and that is a PET CT.
And the PET CT or the PET exam itself is used for all different types of things.
It's used mostly for cancer. There is some work we do in cardiology, and we do a lot of work in neurology, particularly in the field of Alzheimer's.
Oh, that's great. All right. Well, thank you so much for the information. It was very nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
And remember, if you want additional information about what we just discussed, please visit radnet.com.
summertime blues.
And I'd like to welcome from the Baby Boomers Club, we have Pam Ellerman and Jeff Sinclair. And today they're on to talk about the Woodstock event. Now that's not until July 27th, but we're going to tell you all about it. And it's going to be at Clubhouse 2. You saw the video there from last year, and this one is going to be bigger and better. So welcome.
Thank you.
Great to have you both here today. Yeah. So one of the things, Pam, you wanted to talk about today is shuttle service.
Right. Yeah, this year we're providing shuttle service, and it's going to be available from 11:30 in the morning till 9:30 in the evening.
Okay.
So on the shuttle buses, you can take a small cooler and a chair. You couldn't be bringing large items. So
right.
What we've done is there's a designated area at Clubhouse 2
mm-hmm.
that's a drop-off area.
Okay.
So you'll be able to drive over there, drop off everything, and then drive to one of the shuttle
okay.
pickup places, which is Clubhouse 1. There's one place,
mm-hmm.
the community center, and also over on Santa Maria and Moulton by the big lots in that parking lot, the shuttle buses will be.
Oh, okay.
So they're going to run continuously.
All right, so they're allowing people to park in that
area.
That
yes.
area. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Because
those are
that's
three parking areas.
Okay. All right. I didn't realize that. Now, also, you have an event sponsor now, right?
We do, and we're
very excited.
Oh,
very excited.
We're so thrilled that we have United Healthcare.
Mm-hmm. And they'll have like a booth there, I assume, or
they'll have
a presence. We're not really
okay.
sure.
Okay.
Booth or banners
yeah.
or something.
All right.
Like that.
Now, of course, this year you're having a lot of music, just like last year.
Just like last year. And thanks for having us, by the way.
Yeah.
I just wanted to give a peace and love sign out to everybody out there mm-hmm. that is a Woodstock fan and
right.
certain people that are looking at the show this morning. The bands, this is, by the way, if you've been to Woodstock before, fantastic. If you've never been there before, you've got to come to this one. And even if you've been there before, this one is going to blow everyone else that we've had away.
Mm-hmm.
Diane Johansson has done an amazing, spectacular job. David Deering's done a phenomenal job. The entire Baby Boomers board has been incredible with this particular event. It's going to go from 12 o'clock to 9. The bands are ridiculous. We have a total of 8 bands. We have 3 featured bands. One of them is going to start off with Santana Smooth, obviously a Santana mm-hmm. tribute band. And then the second one is going to be Fortunate Son, which is a Creedence Clearwater Revival band. I've heard
okay.
these bands and they're absolutely amazing. And then wrapping up the night is going to be The Who Experience.
Okay.
And that obviously is a tribute band for The Who. Then we have 5 local bands. So from 12 o'clock noon to 9 at night, there's going to be music all day long. The 5 local bands are The Rock of Ages,
mm-hmm.
The Dutch of Fizz,
mm-hmm.
The Woods Combo, and the Village Folk Singers, and then we're going to create an all-star band with a bunch of people from the different bands. I'll be performing in 3 of the bands that day, so it's
okay.
going to be a lot of fun, a lot of dancing, a lot of great music, and this year they are bringing in a canopy
okay.
for the outside area, because the outside stage is going to be built right outside of Clubhouse
2. Okay, and that's what's a little different. You were saying this year they're going to have like, for lack of a better term, a real stage.
They're going to have a
yeah.
real stage.
Before they
this
just
year.
Had, like you saw there, a riser, and that was about it.
Exactly,
yeah.
exactly. Maybe it might be a riser, but it's going to be high enough where
okay.
people are going to be able to
okay.
see the bands.
Right.
But the nice thing is, last year, my band performed outside, and it was so hot.
Oh, yeah.
People were dancing in the shade underneath the...
Yeah, of course.
But,
yeah, that's hard. Yeah.
So this year, we've got a canopy to cover the entire patio of Clubhouse 2, so it's going to be nice. We're bringing in possibly some commercial fans to get some wind blowing and stuff there. So it's going to be wonderful. Make sure you come out because you're going to hear about this. If you didn't attend, you're going to be sorry you did.
So yeah, that's good with the canopy.
Yes, yeah, absolutely.
Now, of course, the food. Who's providing the food, or are there going to be food vendors, food trucks? How is that working this year?
Okay. Well, what we're doing is for the people that come early to set up, there's going to be coffee, bagels, and pastries that are available to purchase. And then also Cafe 19 is going to be doing hot dogs, hamburgers,
wraps, salads.
Okay.
And French fries.
Yeah.
Yeah, everybody wanted French fries. So we're going to have French fries.
Okay, French fries. And now, the, what about, I have a question. Do they have to go to Cafe 19 or they're going to have a setup outside?
It's going to be set up outside.
Okay,
yeah,
all right.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And it's going to be, there's a lot of food. You can bring your own food, of course, and you can get there at 7 a.m. and set up your easy ups and your chairs and get your coolers all set for the day. It's going to be fantastic.
And then also in the afternoon, there'll be cookies and brownies.
Okay.
Now, for purchase.
You were telling me wristbands,
yes.
which is basically, you know, you purchase a wristband instead of tickets.
Right, right. I know the flyer says tickets, but, and some people did get tickets earlier, and they'll have to exchange those for a wristband.
Okay.
So you put the wristband on, you can come and go as you please.
Right,
type
right. And that's how everyone does that now.
Exactly. And wristbands are available if you go to babyboomersclub.org.
Okay.
Or if you see Sandy Bassler or any of the board members of the Baby Boomers.
Okay.
Or the First Friday Social coming up the 5th of July.
Okay.
Is Clubhouse 7.
That's what I was going to ask. If somebody goes to the website, how do they, what do they get? They get an email confirmation and then they, the day of the event, they exchange that for a wristband? How does that work?
That's a great question, Kim.
Okay.
How does that work, Pamela?
You know how it works, Pamela?
I have no idea.
Okay, we'll find out. Because people are going to want to know that.
Yes, like, they can pay online by credit card this year. You can actually buy your wristband at the event.
Okay.
So you can come there, buy it there, pay with a credit card. We've got
They'll
that
probably
all.
Have will call, I would imagine, if you buy it
okay.
online.
Okay,
yeah.
There'd
right.
be a will call.
Okay, so that's something that I was wondering about. Now you're going to have a photo booth, am I right?
Right, and this is something new, and this is going to be free.
Okay.
And it's they get a 4x6 glossy picture, and on the bottom it's printed Woodstock 2019, and you'll be able to do costumes or wear a wig, or there'll be a lot of different props that you can put on.
Okay.
And
that's
it's,
nice.
And it's free. And you'll have a wonderful 4x6
very good
memory.
That's a nice
yeah, so
memory.
The Clown Club is going to be there doing the face painting. They're also going to be doing temporary tattoos.
Okay.
So, and then you dress up in all your Woodstock regalia and great memorial photo take.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
Yeah.
Now, you want to talk about, too, a map and all their...
This is different. This is different than we've ever done before.
Okay.
Where we've actually created... there's so much to do with this thing. I mean, you're going to want to be there from 12 to 9 because there's so many things to do. We've created a program that identifies what bands are playing at what times
and
what
good.
Locations.
That, yeah, that's really good.
And a map there to, if you want to know where the clowns are doing the face painting or the tattooing, or if you want to know where Cafe 19 is set up, it'll all be on a nice map there in a trifold that you'll be able to just plan your day. It's going to be really
great.
Okay.
And Pam, there's going to be a country store?
Right. This year we're doing a country store, and the crafters will be in there, and they'll be selling hats and headbands. There'll be jewelry for sale.
Oh, that's nice. And these are the crafters here from the from like Clubhouse 4 type thing.
Exactly.
Oh, how nice.
Exactly.
And
that's
on
really
the
good.
Map, it's going to show you right where the crafters
that's fantastic.
Are going to be located.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's really good. Now, some of these crafters, do they still have time to sign up? If they want to be a part of this, how do they do that, Jeff?
They would go to babyboomersclub.org and then make contact there. And we do have time because it's not until July 27th.
Yeah, so, because I'm sure there's people who are like, hey, I want to be a part of that.
And so, somebody wants to whip out a quilt or something to sell.
Quilts take a while. I know that because my wife and mother-in-law worked on a... It's like it was a year-long quilt. So.
Oh my goodness!
Long story.
No quilting.
And we'll have local businesses there as well that have tables set up, and you'll be able to maybe participate. Like for example, the Laguna Cafe is going to be there. They'll be offering T-shirts that say Woodstock 2019 Laguna
very
Woods,
good.
Along with their logo and this stuff. It's going to be great there.
All right. Very good. Well, again, this isn't happening until July 27th, but you can get your wristbands now, or find out that you can sign up for them, and then we'll get information on how you actually receive them. Babyboomersclub.com. You can also
.org.
Excuse me. You can email them at babyboomersclub@gmail.com for more information.
Right. Fantastic.
Pam, Jeff, thank you.
Oh well, thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Appreciate your time.
We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm John Bowser Bauman. You probably know me best as Bowser from Shawnee, but I'm also president of Social Security Works PAC. And you know, when I'm in Laguna Woods, I always watch Village Television. Grease for peace.
I came from Western Massachusetts. Okay. And there's a lot of folks that seem to come from like the Boston area here, and the area of the East Coast. And then I came out here in 1979, and I started working in the Saturday morning cartoon houses. It was called Filmation, mm-hmm. and I drew Fat Albert, Heckle and Jekyll, and Flash Gordon. That's how I learned to become an animator. And then I kept applying at Disney and applying at Disney, because I heard they admire perseverance. So on the fourth time, they said, we admire your persistence. You're coming into our training program. So I did, and that was the start of a 24-year love affair and experience with that company. And here now.
Wow.
Yeah, living the life. But I think, that's one of the things that people do now, is that we sort of compartmentalize our story so that we can sort of pick the highlights of what, because our lives are long before we come to the Village, so it's really kind of challenging. But I worked at Disney for 24 years, and after I left there, I went back to school. I was an adult learner. I went to college as an adult. And then after I got my, I completed my master's degree and my doctorate, and I went to work in the public sector, which is very different from working in the private sector, such as Disney. So I was the head of training for the city of Pasadena, and I retired from as the head of training for the Metrolink organization, which is our regional railroad. And that was it.
Wow.
My whole life. 25 words or less.
So you were telling me an interesting story about Roy Disney in Russia.
Well, if you have to say what was one of the, like most sensational experiences in your work life, Disney had a lot of them, but one time it was around 1990, and it was the period when the Soviet Union, just before the Soviet Union fell, and it was called Perestroika and Glasnost, mm-hmm. which was a cultural exchange. Well, Madame Gorbachev called the Disney Corporation, and she wanted Roy Disney and his wife Patty, and a few, there were 14 of us, and we went over to the Soviet Union. We brought 4 animated films with us, because they wanted to share those with as many people as they could get into the theaters, because they'd never seen these movies. And the Moscow airport was shut down when we arrived there, and we rode through the middle of Moscow in a motorcade. And I mean, it was absolutely remarkable. It was really remarkable. It was an unusual event, to say the least.
That sounds pretty cool.
It was very cool. Very cool.
So I know you're involved in a lot of activities here. You're hosting Discovering Laguna Woods Village. Did you have TV experience before? Is that your first TV show you've done?
Well, no, I not camera work. I've done a lot of presenting. I presented all over the world. Disney sent me to Singapore and Hong Kong and London and Paris and Moscow, but other places where we were actually recruiting for regional offices there. So I would go into schools primarily and recruit young artists to work in the regional offices so that they could produce product. I mean, Disney was going through a period of rapid growth, and so they needed to staff up these offices. So they sent me all over the world, and it was amazing, absolutely amazing. So I presented a lot, but I wasn't on camera. That's new.
So you're a natural.
No, I don't know about that. I practice talking to my refrigerator. That's my secret.
So your jewelry work is very, very interesting.
Clubhouse 4 is the most remarkable thing, and I mentioned it in one of my shows as I was talking to Yvonne Lowe. I said, when I walked past the display windows in Clubhouse 4, that was the thing that said, you need to move here because there are people here who make this amazing work, and maybe you can meet them and maybe they can share their skills with you, and they do. They're so generous with their time. So we have great artists that live here and train others and the emeritus program. So I mean, it's like a whole new life. It's like a sandbox for grown-ups. It really is. So I love that aspect of it. You're always on a learning curve.
What other clubs or groups are you working with, hanging out with?
Well, I do yoga, and that's become a new passion of mine, and I feel it actually changing me over time. If you do it regularly, it's a really nice benefit of having the time to learn yoga and to practice yoga. Mm-hmm. The television show takes up some time, but that's great because I'm always meeting new people. I'm always finding people that have interesting lives and stories, and they're just so wonderful to meet. And we're so lucky that we can just walk wherever we're going, stop, say hello, and find out something about someone who might have come from across town or across the world. Yeah. It's amazing.
Everybody has a bucket list, right, Cindy? Tell us some about your bucket list.
Well, I already checked off two things since I've lived here in 3 years. I learned to swim, and also I learned to ride a horse. I went over to the stables and, you know, did that for a while.
You never rode a horse before you lived here?
No. No, and I wanted to. And there were horses all around me when I was growing up, and I was always afraid of them. It's similar to the fear I had of water, a fear of horses, so I'm knocking off all my phobias. But that was terrific, and once I got that out of my system, I said, okay, I can move on to something else now. But yeah, a few more things to check off.
So now you're a regular horse rider?
No, I just got it out of my system, yeah. I went a few times, and I accomplished that, and then I think the beginning of the fear started to come back, so I said, okay, let's move on to something else, maybe go back to that, but it's just nice to have it. Who has an equestrian center? It's amazing.
Nobody. You look like you could surf. You thought about trying to surf?
Well, okay. I moved up from learning how to float and swim to paddle. I have paddleboarded. Okay. I have paddleboarded. But you know what I really spend a lot of time doing?
The nap.
Yeah, that's on my bucket list. To be able to, in the middle of the afternoon, sit down and just close your eyes. I never could do that when I was working. It wouldn't do. So now I can.
They call that the guilt-free nap.
It's a guilt-free nap for sure. Yep. Just you know, waste a half an hour and get up and do something else. So, yeah, that's why awesome. Not?
Well, thanks, Cindy. It's been really fun. I'm glad we had this chance to sit down and talk.
Thanks for coming over, Mark. It was fun.
At our new Memorial Wave Imaging Center in Laguna Woods, formerly Orange County Diagnostics, you can expect the same precise imaging, multiple modalities for your imaging needs, and the same friendly staff with medical providers like Dr. Syed Shirokhni. The Laguna Woods Transportation Service offers convenient access right to our door, and we continue to provide the care and compassion that you expect from our new Wave Laguna Woods location.
And with the American Legion, we have a couple guests on today, and they're going to be talking about a few different things. I'd like to welcome Alan Clark and Dennis Powell. Gentlemen, welcome.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great to have you here today.
Great to be here.
And, you know, first, let's just talk about, I think a lot of people know what the American Legion is, but there might be a few people who don't. Is this, I think one of the biggest questions people ask, is this part of the military? Is this run by our government or is it separate?
It's separate.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's kind of post-military
veterans organization.
Yeah. Yeah. That's the main primary objective is to help veterans. Also, we help out actual active duty military and their family with various things. Mm-hmm. Being right here, we have a connection with the Marines in Camp Pendleton and that. Sometimes we go down and we'll help out, volunteer for various things, even in the schools and that. Sometimes we need to provide things, physical things or whatever, for the families in that because they're just not getting enough, they don't make enough money to cover all that. And then if somebody's deployed and the family's there and trying to make connections and all that type of thing.
So it's mainly a, sort of a benevolent organization,
yes.
Right? And although you might work with different parts of the military, you know, mm-hmm. Veterans Affairs or help vets find their way into getting benefits and things like that, you're really more self-sustained, right?
Yes.
The American Legion is the largest veterans organization in the country.
Mm-hmm.
It's its eligibility requirement is that you serve during wartime.
Okay.
For example, I served during Vietnam, but they never deployed me there, so I could not join the Veterans of Foreign Wars. But I am eligible for the American Legion because I served within the dates of that they've established for World War II.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, absolutely. They're trying to open it up as we speak to include veterans who have fought in conflicts that were not declared wars
mm-hmm.
because they made the same sacrifices and served their country.
Right. Okay.
And so we're really an organization that promotes patriotism and Americanism and service.
Right, right. So as far as your post here, Post 257, it's been around for quite a while, right?
It's been down for 52 years.
So really since this community began.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. What's interesting is 1967 is the year I got out of the Air Force. And we have this, the city of Laguna Woods Certificate of Commendation, American Legion Post 257 for the 50th anniversary. Whereas American Legion Post 257 was formed in Laguna Woods January 1967 by a small group of veterans with a mission statement of veterans helping veterans.
Yeah.
So.
And it's interesting, you handed me this sheet here, that, you know, really the history of the American Legion, although it was different back then, mm-hmm. in a sense, you know, goes back to
Revolutionary
time, 1778. Yeah. It was called the American Legion of Honor, and I've read about that, and the more the modern day one really started in the First World War.
In 1919.
As it is today, so to speak.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. Very interesting.
That's kind of interesting about that. What happened was I think it was like 700,000 troops over there in Europe. And so when the conflict was over, we had people in hospitalized situation, but you also had problem with getting all those folks back who wanted to come back. So they, the United States Army formed a group of officers to be in charge, like the hospital and the dispersion
coordinate.
Feeding, so on and so forth. And so those officers formed a group, basically the American Legion,
mm-hmm.
strictly officers, eventually letting in enlisted personnel. So it expanded to that. So actually it started in France. American Legion post number one is in Paris, France.
Wow.
That's where it started, 1919. And so then as people came back, they started forming the groups here and, you know, people were back and they were on the saddle and then all of a sudden, like, okay, let's get this going. And just in a very short time, it was hundreds of thousands of people getting involved in it. And,
quite interesting.
Yeah.
Now, one of the things that you want to talk about today is through the Veterans Administration, the GI Bill.
Yes.
And of course, one of the members, William Price was one of the past commanders here at 257, and he used the GI Bill after World War II to become a physicist, right?
That's correct.
and went on to help with the Voyager mission, and we've had him on in the past.
Okay, if I can read this quickly.
Sure.
William Price used his GI Bill education after World War II to become a leading physicist who helped the Voyager mission pass through the Jupiter's fierce energy belt. So there's a whole article. It's just one of many people that have been helped out so much by the GI Bill. Mm-hmm. I think we both used it, you know, and that. So, yeah.
Now, we got some photos up here, and you talked about, you know, before we came on here, all the different things you do. Mm-hmm. You often go to school graduations as the color guard, and then you honor some students here. We see in a photo in the background. Yeah. And of course, you know, on more solemn occasions, you show up with the color guard and officers for maybe a military vet that has passed away.
Right. That gentleman is going to be the new commander.
That's Joe Rainey.
Yes.
Joe Rainey.
Yeah,
okay.
Joe Rainey, yes.
You're kind of acquainted. He's only been here 100 years or something.
Yeah. Like
and the young lady he's with was the valedictorian of the graduating class. He's presenting her with a certificate of, I think, for achievement for her grades as well.
Oh, how nice.
Oh,
yeah.
Brilliant. It's interesting to see these young people and how much they're so much into
Yeah, and we see this photo here. Is that that's Bill Price there, I think?
Yes, it is. And that's Lou Tirado. He's 98 years old. The gentleman the closest to us turned away from us and that. And then some of the other folks in there. This was for the Armistice Day thing, whatever we had.
Program.
Memorial Day.
You know, one of the nice things, you folks do a lot of great things, but I think one of the nicest things, or the greatest thing about all this, is, you know, they're former vets that want to be part of something, and they're not sure do I want to be part of, you know, the this club, the Lions Club, this club, which are, they're all great organizations too, but I think they feel a camaraderie by being a part of the American Legion, and whether it's your post or, you know, finding a post in their area, right?
Yeah. One of the photos that was up there a minute ago was a color guard, which we do various things like schools and services. That service was at Lutheran Church of the Cross and that. And now we have up the veteran canine, and that was interesting. He trains the dogs for the vets.
Oh, how nice.
Now, he's the kind of basic instructor. As I recall, he was a Navy SEAL.
Mm-hmm.
The gentleman standing in the background is somebody that PTSD suffered in that, and it's his dog that was trained for
him.
And it's just marvelous to see these things happen and how much that contact makes help with the
You do
that,
an awful lot.
Yeah.
I do want to mention, we're putting up on the screen now, that you have your monthly dinners, and the next one coming up on Thursday, June 27th at Dining Room 1, and it's a cost is $15 per person, and the program is Hawaiians at Heart.
Yeah, it's Clubhouse 1, main dining room. Yeah,
That's good.
Yeah. So, yeah,
I like
we're
the
gonna
theme of that.
that's going to be my farewell party. That'll be in my term. And then in September, Joe Rainey will take over.
Okay.
But you're not leaving us.
You're not leaving him. And if somebody wants to join up, what's the best way that they can do it?
The best way right now is to go on internet to al257.org.
Okay.
American Legion 257 org.
.org.
Okay. .org. Yeah. And by the way, if somebody belongs, they may belong to a different post and they moved in here.
You transfer.
Is that what you do? You kind of transfer? And,
Because I moved down from Big Bear, so I transferred from the Big Bear from 584 up there.
I moved to Laguna Beach, I belonged to American Legion California. I did not belong to a local post because I didn't have one close to my home.
So there's all different options.
And when I moved down here, I have more time than I used to have, and the post is local, and I'm very eager to get more actively involved with the the environment, the social environment in this country today. We're very eager to get our message of our patriotism and Americanism out to the public, because usually all you hear about is the other side.
Right. Well, very good. I want to thank both of you for coming on today. It's an honor. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your service,
been
of course.
A pleasure.
Yes, and again, if you want to be part of the dinner, now, do you have to be a member to go to this dinner?
No, you don't.
Okay,
you're
and that's what's
welcome.
Nice. Maybe you're interested. Yeah. You want to become a member. This is next week, not this Thursday, the following Thursday, June 27th at 5 p.m., the main dining room in Clubhouse 1. It's $15 per person. and you can join them there. Okay. Thank you very
much. Very good. Thank you.
The American Legion, we're a powerful force for the nation. We're the largest veteran service organization in the nation with 2.5 million members. And when you add to that the American Legion Auxiliary and the Sons of the American Legion, we have a family of 4 million members working hard every day for our veterans, our youth, and our communities. Go to legion.org to find out more about the American Legion's commitment of service to America.
Are your hearing aids not working as well as you'd like? The person who programs your hearing aids is way more important than how much you spent on them. The good news is that we can help. I'm a retired electronics engineer who will precisely reprogram your hearing aids to your unique hearing loss. If that doesn't give you significantly better hearing, I won't charge you a dime. You have nothing to lose and better hearing to gain. So call Hearing Remedy right now and ask for your personal better hearing appointment.
I had been with another hospice for my husband, Ed. After about 2 months, I thought, they're not doing much for me. So I went to the computer and brought up the list of hospices, and there was OC. Their response was immediate. They did everything. They had all their ducks in the row, and that's what I was looking for. It was comforting till the very end. And then at the very end, the last 3 days, you know, it was continuous care, and nobody ever left him.
What's happened to healthcare? It wasn't so long ago that your doctor understood your health history because they were part of it. From labor pains to life's health challenges, you could rely on that relationship with your family physician. Then something happened. Healthcare changed. Seeing a doctor can feel like running into a stranger. A 60-minute wait for a 6-minute visit. Hoag Medical Group is here to change all of that. Our doctors do more than react to illness. They become your personal physician for life. Always listening, never rushing, helping to chart a healthy path together, walking with you at every turn. This is the way healthcare was meant to be, with enhanced features such as same-day appointments, care coordination, and direct access to Hoag's world-class professionals and services. Hoag Medical Group. We listen. We care. We're committed to you for life.
Our movie today is Second Act. It stars Jennifer Lopez, and it's about a woman who works at a big box store. She reinvents her life and her life story and shows Madison Avenue what street smarts can do. It's kind of interesting where I don't know if it's her son or her friend's son, but creates basically a fake profile for her online that gives her all these different things she hasn't really done in her life. And a big company kind of sees it, invites her in for an interview, and it's a comedy, drama, and romance. And this came out last year. Jennifer Lopez, as I said, Vanessa Hudgens, and Lee Remini are in this, and we bring that to you today at 2 and 6 o'clock. All right, our weather today, if you've looked outside, if you're watching us this morning, it was a little drizzly this morning, very heavy marine layer. This isn't really so much rain as it is a very thick marine layer, but you know, we got a little bit of rain on our little bit of moisture on our rain gauge overnight, so it is out there. Got a fairly cool week. The June gloom is in full force certainly today. I think we'll get some sun as we get to the latter part of the day, probably late afternoon, early evening, as will most days. So not a lot of sun, but that's all right. We're going to be hitting it pretty hard, you know, as we get another month from now. So I'm welcoming this. All right, we will see you tomorrow. You take care.